Back-to-back champions. The Black Ferns Sevens team have won their second consecutive World Cup. The team, captained by Sarah Goss, whipped France 29-0 in the final this afternoon. One News reporter Guy Havelt is in San Francisco. Guy.
Evening, Peter. It's been quite the staggering performance from the Black Ferns Sevens throughout this entire tournament. They're only briefly tested once in the semi-final against the United States. Their three other matches, they won to nil. And they now have more silverware to show for their efforts. The Golden Girls in black on top of the Sevens world again.
They are a force of nature at the moment.
The Black Ferns Sevens crushing France 29-0 in the final of the World Cup in San Francisco to continue their domination of the women's game. This win adding to their Commonwealth Games gold, making 2018 one to cherish.
This has been one hell of a year. You couldn't script it if you tried. Actually, someone should make a movie about this year, man, straight up.
New Zealand got to the final after some tense moments, causing heartbreak for the home fans with a tight win over the USA in the semi-finals before the French demolition. Ultimately, though, they were in a class of their own, scoring 25 tries and conceding just three, now on a 28-match winning streak. It's back-to-back world titles, the players putting their incredible run down to the culture in the team.
It stems from our head coach, Alan Bunting. He's created this incredible culture where, you know, it's all about each other and working for each other and having each other's back.
You know, never above, never below, always beside.
For Ruby Tui, the San Fran success is extra special. An ill-timed dose of the mumps caused her to miss the gold rush on the Gold Coast.
If I could give you my heart to show you what it means, you know, you'd see what it looks like.
It was a sea of black in the stands after the win too, special for the players, but equally memorable for their travelling families.
Tyler got injured in the training just before the finals in the Commonwealth, so to see her go out there and then score a try as well, I was just like, wow.
More glory for this all-conquering team, who are Sevens Queens again. Guy Havelt, One News, San Francisco.
Well, Guy, for some of these players, I know it's a busy street outside the park there, for some of these players, their second World Cup win in, what, 2 years?
Yeah, that's exactly right, Peter. Sarah Goss, Kelly Brazier, Portia Woodman and Stacey Wacker all won the 15s World Cup over in the UK, as you say, a couple of years ago. So they are in seventh heaven at the moment. But just a little bit on that culture. Alan Bunting came into the side. He's been there for about 6 years. He was an assistant coach. He's now the head coach. And every player I spoke to tonight was singing the praises of him and telling me that is why they've won this tournament, because of the culture that he has built in that team. They were all smiles. You even saw Ruby Tui in the anthem, smiling and laughing and giving it her all. That just sums it up for me. They now have 6 weeks off before they try and do it all again.